night when they were confronted by a white male with a handgun. The suspect did not reportedly say anything before firing four rounds, then running away. Two of the students were listed in stable condition, while the third suffered serious injuries. Police say the investigation is in the early stages, and they haven't indicated if they're calling the shooting a hate crime. Senator Michael Bennett believes there's broad bipartisan support in the Senate for an aid package that includes Ukraine, but concedes the support likely is not there in the House. Speaking on CBS's Face the Nation, the Colorado Democrat was referring to President Biden's request for a combined $14 billion aid package that combines Ukraine, Israel, Southeast Asia, and the U.S.-Mexico border. Bennett stressed the importance of continuing support for Ukraine, not just for the country itself, but for democracy as a whole. The latest movie in the Hunger Games series is setting the pace at the weekend box office. The Hunger Games, The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes, earned $11.4 million on Black Friday. That's double the take for Disney's animated feature Wish, and well ahead of Napoleon, which round out the top three for the holiday weekend. You're listening to The Latest. I'm Tammy Trujillo.
You're on board KCAA's Inland Talk Express. KCAA, Loma Linda, 1050 AM, the station that leaves no listener behind.
Tahibo Tea Club's original Pure Pouty Arco Super Tea comes from the only tree in the world that fungus does not grow on. As a result, it naturally has antifungal, anti-infection, antiviral, antibacterial, anti-inflammation, and anti-parasite properties. So the tea is great for healthy people because it helps build the immune system, and it can truly be miraculous for someone fighting a potentially life-threatening disease due to an infection, diabetes, or cancer. The tea is also organic and naturally caffeine-free. A one-pound package of tea is $49.95, which includes shipping. To order, please visit TahiboTeaClub.com. Tahibo is spelled T like Tom, A-H-E-E-B like boy, O, then continue with the word tea and then the word club. The complete website is TahiboTeaClub.com or call us at 818-610-8088, Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. California time. That's 818-610-8088, TahiboTeaClub.com.
Apex Bulk Commodities would like to recognize and salute our veterans and local men and women in uniform. Let's remember them with our thoughts, prayers, and especially letters and packages from home. Our support will keep America strong. This important reminder from Apex Bulk Commodities in Adelanto, providing safe and efficient trucking and transfer services. Learn more about them online, including employment opportunities at apexbulk.com.
This segment sponsored by the all-new Rams Market, Rams Express Car Wash, and the Rams Ultimate One-Stop Shop at 2090 Mentone Boulevard on the corner of Crafton Hills Avenue, just across from Jacinto Farms. Rams is now open, all-new, well-stocked, bringing fresh and sharp convenience to Mentone with their clean, safe chemicals that leave your car all shiny and protected. When you buy gas inside the One-Stop Shop, you'll get savings on your car wash, make life easy, and sweeten it all with Rams. You can save with the dinosaur and their top-tier Sinclair fuel. Rams has great car wash membership deals, and you can save on gas when you wash your car. Satisfy your appetite when you drop in the one-stop shop convenience store. Smell the chicken! Delectable, mouth-watering, crispy, crunchy fried chicken, that is. Rams is now open at 2090 Mentone Boulevard in Mentone. Thank you to Rams for their community spirit and sponsoring this radio station. Rams and Mentone is waiting for you.
It's that time of year again. No, not the holidays. Medicare open enrollment. And if you have questions about Medicare, you should talk to the local experts, Paul Berich and Associates. Paul and his agents are certified with plans that are accepted by most of the medical groups in our area. Call 909-793-0385. Their service is free, and after 42 years in the business, their agents are trained to help you pick the plan that's right for you.
For over a century, AM radio has evolved to meet the needs of our community. More than 80 million listeners depend on AM radio each month. It's also the backbone of the emergency alert system, keeping us safe in dangerous times. A new bill in Congress would ensure this free, reliable service remains in cars. Text AM to 52886 and tell Congress to support the AM Radio for Every Vehicle Act.
Message and data rates may apply. You may receive up to four messages a month, and you may text STOP to STOP.
This message furnished by the National Association of Broadcasters.
Redlands Ranch Market is a unique full-service international grocery store that specializes in authentic food items from Mexico, India, and from many Mediterranean and Asian countries, including popular items from the U.S. They offer fresh baked items from their in-house bakery, house-made tortillas from their tortilleria, a delicious array of prepared Mexican foods, a terrific fresh fruit and juice bar, and a large selection of meats, seafoods, and deli sandwiches, salads, and halal meats. Their produce department is stocked full with fresh local and hard-to-find international fruits and vegetables that you cannot find anywhere else. Don't forget to stop into the massive Beer Cave and experience the largest selection of domestic, artisan, and imported beers in the IE. They can also cater your next event with one of their delicious takeout catering trays of food. Visit them at RedlandsRanchMarket.com. That's RedlandsRanchMarket.com. Redlands Ranch Market, a unique and fun shopping destination.
What is your plan for your beneficiaries to manage your final expenses when you pass away? Life insurance, annuities, bank accounts, investment accounts, all require a death certificate, which takes 10 days based on the national average, which means no money is immediately available, and this causes stress and arguments. Simple solution, the beneficiary liquidity plan. Use money you already have. No need to come up with additional funds. The funds grow tax-deferred and pass tax-free to your named beneficiary. The death benefit is paid out in 24 to 48 hours without a death certificate. You heard me right. Without a death certificate. Call us at 1-800-306-5086. What is your plan for your beneficiaries to manage your final expenses when you pass away? Life insurance, annuities, bank accounts, investment accounts, all require a death certificate, which takes 10 days based on the national average, which means no money is immediately available, and this causes stress and arguments. Simple solution, the beneficiary liquidity plan. Use money you already have, no need to come up with additional funds. The funds grow tax-deferred and pass tax-free to your named beneficiary. Death benefit is paid out in 24 to 48 hours without a death certificate. You heard me right. Without a death certificate. Call us at 1-800-306-5086.
How you doing? This is Gary Garver. In today's society, the majority of people are not getting enough sleep. I know I'm not. If you're like me and having problems getting a good night's rest, whether it's health or stress related, I have a solution for you. South Pacific Sleep Lab. South Pacific Sleep Lab will do an evaluation of your sleep pattern and will provide a comprehensive study so you can start getting a restful, peaceful night of sleep. They take all types of insurance, which will cover your cost of the evaluation, and they will even provide transportation to their offices at no cost to you. For more information, contact Tony at 310-999-1887. That's 310-999-1887. Tony even stays awake all night, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so you can sleep better and rest easy. South Pacific Sleep Lab. Start feeling better and getting a great night of sleep today.
Why are you listening to this radio station? Why? When you can host your own radio show. You're listening and you think you can do better? You have a message or a product you want everyone to know about. Host your own radio show. Team up with the area's best radio professionals and let them make you sound like you should be on NBC. KCAA NBC Radio, that is. KCAA produces more than 50 local programs each week on subjects ranging from business and sports to political talk, vegan diets, or even marijuana-related issues. We don't just broadcast on the radio, we broadcast to the world, online, on TV, on social media, on Facebook. You'll be all over. Imagine what your friends will say. And KCAA reaches over 5 million people. Join the staff on 1050 AM and 106.5 FM, NBC Radio. Jump on the KCAA Express. Call 909-793-1065. That's 909-793-1065 and get ready to transmit.
The caring staff at Mac Flavor Ingredients reminds everyone to please take the opportunity to give blood. By doing so, you may save the life of a friend, child, elderly person, surgery patient, or an accident victim. So give blood. It's safe, simple, and saves lives. This important reminder is a courtesy of Mac Flavor Ingredients in Riverside, where they care about the safety and welfare of our community. Be a silent hero, and if you can, give the gift of life. Give blood.
If you are trying to quit drinking or doing too many drugs, listen to me. You don't know me and we'll never meet. I had a problem like you once. I drank and used to party a little too much till it got out of control and almost ruined my life. I realized I needed help to fix my problem before it totally destroyed me. If you've tried to fix your drinking and drug problem and you know you can't do it alone, you need to call the National Treatment Advisors. They'll immerse you into a 30-day program to replace your old habits with new habits and totally change your life. And if you have PPO private health insurance, the entire program may be covered. Fix your problem right now before it gets any worse. Get clean. Call now and learn more.
800-451-9716. 800-451-9716. 800-451-9716. That's 800-451-9716.
This segment is sponsored by PressPrint, Southern California's best full-service union printer and mailhouse. They offer the lowest prices around with unmatched service and reliability and free delivery throughout SoCal. PressPrint can print anything from letterhead, business cards, and campaign literature to mailers of any size, lawn signs, banners, door hangers, or just about anything you might want. PressPrint promises to save money for you, your business, or your campaign. If you'd like to learn more, contact Mike Krumbrin at PressPrint, 714-399-8777. Get the union bug.
And thank you for being a part of The Real Men of Real Estate. Here's another episode with your host, Thomas F. Chappelle Jr. I am the organizer of the Black Inland Empire Real Estate Investment Club. I am also the host here at the radio show. I'm also an investor, entrepreneur, everything of the above. Let me give you my info and then we gonna get into our guests. Okay. Number is 404-844-1828. Once again, that's area code 404-844-1828. My email is thomaschappelle33@yahoo.com. Once again, that's T-H-O-M-A-S, C like Charles, H like Harry, A like Apple, P like Paul, E like Edward, L like Larry, 33 at yahoo.com. Our guest was supposed to be live, but he's going to be on the radio. We'll do the live portion later on because it is being recorded. My guest here is okay, he's on the break. Okay, Bruce Blaylock, are you there?
Yes, Thomas, how are you today?
I'm all right. We're having a little technical difficulty, so I do apologize, ladies and gentlemen, as well as to Bruce. Bruce is a oh man, he's an amazing guy. You know, that's not a other thing, but you know, I'm gonna give Bruce a little heck right now because you know he's out there in Brooklyn. I'm from Bronx, so you know that's kind of like eh. But I'll give him a pass right about now. So Bruce, how you doing on this lovely evening for you on the East Coast and for me on the West Coast? How you doing today?
I'm doing absolutely amazing, Thomas. Absolutely amazing.
I appreciate you giving me this opportunity to talk to you now. A lot of people don't know anything about you or what you do, so why don't you do us a favor and introduce yourself and tell people who you are.
Sure. My name is Bruce Blaylock of the Blaylock Consulting Group, and what we are is a management consultant strategic advisory firm. We put together corporate sales strategies for businesses, strategic marketing plans, creative distribution programs. We do organizational engineering. We do infrastructure expansion. We will often help to put systems in place to make businesses more efficient, more consistent, more productive, more profitable. But, Thomas, what we're most famously known for is our ability to creatively raise capital using strategies that are not only out of the box, but help us to overcome and our clients to overcome a lot of the roadblocks and challenges they come up against when they're trying to obtain capital to launch and expand their businesses. We not only raise the capital, but what makes us very unique is we identify immediate income-producing assets, businesses, so to speak, that our clients can put the money that they raise into that will service the debt, create wealth, but not just any wealth, but generational wealth for their family.
Okay, wait a minute. I'm going to stop you right there.
We are a one-stop shop, and we're able to do this and have our successful funding by our credit repair strategy that repairs, rebuilds, and enhances credit.
Okay, I'm going to stop you right there, okay? Because, ladies and gentlemen, if you have not heard anything this gentleman said, he is talking about financing for personal as well as business endeavors and whatnot. And that's one of the major things people have and when it comes to personal and business is that how can I be able to have the capital to do the things that I need to do? And before we get into that, give me a little history about who you are, you know, what have you done, and how did you get to this point? So, you know, if you don't mind, just give me a little history of who Mr. Blaylock is, you know. Where did he come from? Is he always been in New York, or did he move to New York, or what? Give me a little bit of background on that.
I was actually born and raised in Queens, New York, and I've moved and lived in Westchester County. I've lived in Connecticut. I've lived in Brooklyn. I'm actually currently right now living in Suffolk County, New York City, New York, the New York area. And, you know, this all started for me years and years and years ago. I used to manage large sales organizations for big companies. I would hire, train, manage, and build sales organizations for billion-dollar companies. And one day I was talking to my executive vice president, and he said to me, he said, you know, the systems, the methods, the techniques, the strategies that you have put in place for our company has helped our division and region to grow 40%, which was $250 million region. And he said, you know, I got to thank you. You're doing incredible work. And, you know, I thought to myself, wait a second. I've helped $250 million region grow by 40%, and I'm not a millionaire. And I said, something's wrong with this. And it, to make a very long story short, it led me into a path of aggressively pursuing entrepreneurship to do this for myself rather than build someone else's company. I said, I need to be putting these strategies, these efforts, these techniques and methodologies that I've designed that I'm not only training individuals but training managers. I need to do this for myself and build my own business. And to make a very long story short, I partnered up with some people I went to school with, fraternity brother, and we launched a management consulting venture capital firm. And there is where I learned a lot of strategies on funding and strategies in terms of management consulting. And I added the strategies that I came to the table with the new strategies that I learned, and I eventually started and launched my own management consulting strategic advisory firm, which is the Blaylock Consulting Group.
Okay, so we got into that, and you have a degree in what?
I have a degree from Syracuse University in economics with a concentration in finance and marketing. Through my journey of learning and developing my skills, I've served as an expert speaker and a panelist for the NAACP, as well as the African-American Chamber of Commerce. I've also been an adjunct professor at MacArthur College, not only a professor in teaching, but also I've been a strategic partner. They gave me access to their alumni database to market my services to, and the reason why these groups associate and affiliate with me and give me access to their constituency is because I promote and I teach and I push economic development, empowerment, and generational wealth. Often as individuals, we're seeking prosperity, wealth, and abundance. But one of the things that eludes many people is the generational wealth, the ability to have assets that they can pass down on to their next generation. And if there's anything that's more important to me, it's that of which is creating generational wealth for my clients. Now, many of my clients are looking to expand and launch businesses, and one of the things that I teach and I preach is the acquisition of established businesses. 90 to 95% of most businesses fail in the first 5 years. And the reason why they fail, Thomas, is because many of them have not developed or matured their financial model, their business model. They have been established a strategic partnership that enable them to meet the market demands. They haven't defined their demographic strategy or designed a model that reaches the right demographic and vertical market. These things take time, and as a result, many businesses fail in the process. What I do to mitigate that risk is I help my clients to raise enough capital for their businesses, but I also help them to buy additional businesses that services the debt on the business purchased and the businesses that they funded to help it launch and expand. So what's happening is not only is there risk mitigation, but there's wealth creation. And that's done by funding businesses that are established, that are producing at least 40 to 90% in net profits, and are grossing 3 to 10 times their purchase price. And those are the businesses that we identify for our clients so that they can create wealth and have a sustainable model that enables them to service debt and create multiple revenue streams.
Okay, Bruce, let me ask you a question. Now, you gave us a whole lot to swallow right there. Now, let's look at the average individual that does not have the business mindset. You know, I really hate using the word mindset because people use it a lot and they really truly don't understand what that means. Now, we all was raised, and we was raised to go to school, get good grades, go to college, and get a good job with benefits. And that's it. To me, that's being like in the program situation. Now, how can I turn around and use what God has given me and say, renew my mind to understand how can I be able to gain capital when I never had it, or I don't know how to go by getting it, or what's the right criteria that I need to be able to have that kind of capital at all times? Because if I got a credit score of, let's say, 525, you know what I'm saying, knowing that my credit is not all that great, and a lot of people don't understand the true meaning of credit, how can you get them to understand by switching their minds to say, now I understand credit, now I know how to make it work for me, and things like that? Could you expound on that for me, please?
Sure. That's a great question, Thomas. First of all, one of the things that we do, if there's nothing that we do, is education. Financial literacy is a part of our program. We teach it, we preach it, we educate upon it. And we want our clients to understand and know how our business model works. And the reason why we're able to help anyone, and when I say anyone, whether the individuals are entrepreneurial-minded or if they're average, everyday individuals who work 9-to-5 jobs, everybody wants generational wealth. But it eludes individuals because it's hard to obtain, it's hard to position themselves in that way. And the first thing that we teach is credit. Credit is king, and what I mean by that is if you want to expand and launch or fund a business, you need to have credit. You don't want to just use your cash. You want to obtain cash and capital to do that with. And then you want to make sure you put it into the right vehicle that multiplies it and creates revenue streams for you to not only service the debt, which is paying the money back, but to also position yourself for prosperity, wealth, and abundance. We're looking to change the trajectory, the financial trajectory of our clients. So the first thing we do is we teach them about what credit repair is and what that entails. Traditional credit repair is just a company removing derogatories off your credit. And the problem with that is that if that's all you're having done, you can end up having all your credit, negative credit, removed and have a zero credit score. Or you can have 65 to 70% of it removed, which is what most credit repair companies do, and have a credit score in the low to mid 600s. What we do is we repair credit specifically for the strategy and the purpose of funding. Our goal is to get our clients in the mid 700s to low 800s, and the way we're able to ensure that happening is through three processes. It's repairing in removing the most negative derogatories, which we can do. And we remove not the standard stuff like collections, but we can remove the very difficult things like repossession, child support, student loans, civil court judgments, federal tax liens, bankruptcy. So we remove all the very difficult stuff. But what we also do is we rebuild and enhance the credit profile with 7 to 10 primary lines of credit, some that are backdated, some that are not, some that range, some that are retail with $500 to $5,000 limits, some that are installment and revolving lines of credit that range from $1,000 to $25,000 limits. With this portfolio that we provide our clients to, we provide our clients access to, we're able to rebuild and enhance their credit profile so they don't just have a good credit score, but the content of their credit profile is tier one. The score is usually going to be in the 750s to the low 800s, and they're not going to just have a good score, but they'll be highly fundable. So if they want to purchase a car or a house, they're going to have the most premium term, the lowest rate. If they want to go into funding, which is what we always recommend, and to get capital to launch or expand their existing business or purchase, preferably, a new business or an established business, they're going to be able to do that. And what we're able to do for the average person, once we repair, rebuild, and enhance their credit, we're able to usually raise anywhere between $50,000 to $250,000 in funding. And for those clients that have really strong credit and strong financials and significant income, we can reach the $500,000 mark. For businesses that are highly established, we can get into the millions of dollars, but our sweet spot is usually between $50,000 to $250,000 in funding.
Okay, Bruce.
And with that capital, Thomas, we can help individuals purchase businesses that are $50,000 to $150,000 in purchase price. These businesses can net anywhere between $40,000 to $100,000 in net profit and gross $300,000 to $1 million in gross revenue.
Okay, Bruce, I'm about to stop you right there because we're getting ready to take our first commercial break. Ladies and gentlemen, when we get back, we're going to continue this conversation with Mr. Bruce Blaylock. This is the Real Men of Real Estate, your host, Thomas F. Chappelle Jr. We'll be right back after these messages. Thank you.
Fire Up Connect is the most innovative business networking group, supporting and collaborating with a dozen of small businesses that are interested in building and establishing strong business connections, hosting educational live seminars while carrying out business and community-driven projects, as well as marketing programs as a part of its membership program. FireUp Connect also offers virtual assistance with a wide range of services, including inbound customer support, chat support, appointment setting and email management, graphic designing, video editing, web design and development, social media marketing, e-commerce solution, content writing, and much more. For more information, head on over to www.fireupconnect.com. FireUp Connect, helping success stories unfold every day.
Here's Daily Hope with Pastor Rick Warren.
As Americans, we idolize independence. In America, we have the Declaration of Independence. We like songs like, I gotta be me, I'll do it my way, I don't need anybody to tell me what it's all about. And we have bought into a myth that says that the key to happiness is independence. If I have relational independence, financial independence, and independence in every other area of my life, if I don't let anybody get too close to me, but I'm totally self-sufficient, then I will be happy. Obviously, that's not true. And God says that the key to happiness is not independence, but interdependence, that we need each other, we belong to each other, we need community in our lives. And God wired you to go through life not as a solitary individual, but in community.
Hear more from Rick Warren at PastorRick.com. Here's Daily Hope with Pastor Rick Warren.
As Americans, we idolize independence. In America, we have the Declaration of Independence. We like songs like, I gotta be me, I'll do it my way, I don't need anybody to tell me what it's all about. And we have bought into a myth that says that the key to happiness is independence. If I have relational independence, financial independence, and independence in every other area of my life, if I don't let anybody get too close to me, but I'm totally self-sufficient, then I will be happy. Obviously, that's not true. And God says that the key to happiness is not independence, but interdependence, that we need each other. We belong to each other. We need community in our lives. And God wired you to go through life not as a solitary individual, but in community.
Hear more from Rick Warren at PastorRick.com.
Back to the Real Men of Real Estate, hosted by me, Thomas F. Chappelle Jr. Seems like we got a technical difficulty up. We get ready to put out the screen, and we're going to go back into the segment about the credit. Bruce, can you see me now?
I can't see you, but I can hear you.
Okay. Well, we got your picture. We're going to go with that. We're going to let they're going to work on the technical part. We're going to finish our conversation. So as we left to go to our commercial break, let's get back in. Now, I'm going to ask this question. Now, say, for instance, like with me, all my life, my credit was screwed up. I've always had the low fives and things like that. And I didn't start understanding what credit was until my late 40s, early 50s now. So it was always hard for me to maintain my credit. You know, different things like that. Had a lot of, you know, collections and child support, as well as repossessions and things like that. So when you're talking to the average person that truly does not understand what credit's all about, how can you get them to understand, to be able to see what you're talking about as being able to having the A1 credits and having the credit cards to use to have $1 million on there or $5 million, that they can use that power to be able to have as much as they want as far as capital is concerned? If you can expound on that, I appreciate it.
Sure, that's a great question, Thomas. So credit is broken down into a number of categories. People think that having a great score gives you great credit. And actually, it's furthest from the truth. You could have a 750 credit score, but if the content of your credit profile is weak in terms of the amount of lines of credit that you have, it is shallow in its payment history, and it doesn't have the diversity, meaning different types of credit, whether it's revolving, installment loans, mortgages, car loans. If it has these factors that make it weak, you won't be able to attain premium and quality funding terms or large amounts of credit, or loans that will help you to obtain the funding that you desire. So what's important to remember about credit is it's a diverse a tool. It's a tool that needs to be diverse in its nature. It needs to be comprised of payment history, mix and diversity of types of credit, as well as limits, balances, debt to credit ratio, and scores. So these are all the things that comprise of a good credit score. I've had people who've come to me and say, hey, Bruce, my credit is a 750, and I wasn't able to get any loans for more than $1,000 or credit cards for more than $500. And the reason why that is because they had poor payment history, or they had lots of inquiries on their credit, which also affects your credit fundability. So what I want you to understand is that when it comes to credit, that it is a combination of things that enables you to be marked as a good credit risk. And it's not just scores, but it's payment history. It's the credit mix. It is the limits that you have, the debt to credit ratio that you have. So it's a combination of things.
Okay, so what a lot of people that don't understand is that I am a client of Mr. Bruce Blaylock, and the one thing that I did learn from him that I wasn't aware of is trade lines. Could you explain what that is?
Sure. So one of the things that helps to develop a robust credit profile is having multiple lines of credit. And this is very, very important. And the more diverse your lines of credit that you have, the stronger your credit profile, the easier it is for you to reach the high 700s, even to the 800s. So trade lines are credit lines, and there are retail lines like Home Depot, JCPenney, Macy's, and then their institutional lines, which are banks, JP Morgan Chase, Bank of America, TD Bank, Citibank. So when you are trying to build a strong credit profile, you want to have a mix of different types of credit as well too. You want to have a mortgage if you can, obviously paying a mortgage in a beautiful home, that's great. But if having a mortgage, having a car loan, having a revolving lines of credit with preferably large limits, and having installment loans like student loans or loans that you've obtained with limits anywhere between $1,000 to $25,000. This is the diversity that makes up a good credit profile and which will enable you to obtain substantial funding in the best possible terms when getting any type of loans or lines of credit.
Okay, so all that we understand when it comes to credit, because the biggest thing is the challenge is that people, to me, I use the word program because I was programmed and I'm no longer programmed anymore. So things are much simpler to me now, especially since I've been able to get into the business of real estate and understanding how to be an investor, what to invest in, and things of that nature. All the different things that people have a challenge with, you know, and I appreciate the fact that, one, you are a believer in the Heavenly Father. I do appreciate that very, Absolutely. Very well. You know, but not only that you also, not only because of what you do, you are looking at other avenues to expand on what you do personally. And if it's okay with you, I don't mind putting out Bruce and I looking at doing some things collectively together. Now, he is on the East Coast and I am on the West Coast, but we can still be able to, do business together outside of just finances. The real reason why I wanted this gentleman to come on is because not only what is he doing for me, you know, but also what he can bring to the whole entire world, the whole entire nation, for all the things that he does on a smaller scale that a lot of people don't even know about. You know what I'm saying? And if they're not in his arena, they would never know. And I was introduced to him by another gentleman named Marvin Spruill. If I had never met Marvin, I would have never met Bruce, which means that Bruce and I has that relationship that we're working together on a lot of different things. And that's one of the reasons why I wanted to bring him, because he's not just talking about, you know, finances and credit. He's talking about how to consume and to pass on. Now, I don't like using the word generational wealth because it's just too easy for everybody to say generational wealth. What makes you generational wealth is the ability to be able to understand how wealth can work for you, which for you, your network is your net worth. If you feel that you network enough, you're going to find money. Money is the easiest thing to find. People have an issue with money. People say money's not hard. It's not easy to find. Yes, it is, because you never know who you're talking to, and that individual could be your investor, your hard money lender, your private lender, things of that nature, or they can be your business partner. So here's the thing I want to find out from you is that how many multiple things are you out there putting your hands on? Because I know you do a lot, especially with your church and different things like that. If you don't mind expounding on that, please.
Yes. In terms of my church, I've served as a director of the men's ministry. And my goal has been, as a director, not only looking to create disciples, but also providing strategies for men so that they can help be major contributors to their families. I've raised capital for many men in the ministry and the church, and I've sought strategies for those individuals and provided strategies and opportunities for individuals to invest in purchase businesses. The major thing about changing people's financial trajectory is also changing their mindset. And that's done through education, through teaching, through preaching. And it's important that we always are looking to pour into each other and educate each other. A lot of times individuals get information, knowledge, and wisdom, and they keep it to themselves. And, the greatest thing that you can do is to pour into someone else and to teach them how to change their future of the trajectory of their family and their lineage. And, I believe that it's important for us as individuals to always learn, always develop, always grow. And, you know, by the grace of God, you know, allow him to use us as his tool, his vessel, his vehicle, his instrument to build his kingdom and to also do his works. These things are important to me and important to the people that I surround myself with. So, you know, all I can say is that, you know, I'm a work in progress myself, always working on myself. And by the grace of God, he'll continue to use me as a blessing to other individuals in this world.
Okay, so here we're going to do, Bruce. We're going to take our next commercial break. We're going to come back because there's a couple of things I want to point out to you before we end this show. And I mean, it's been a wonderful time speaking with you. So listen, ladies and gentlemen, please do not leave this dial. There's more coming back from my guest, Bruce Blaylock. This is The Real Men of Real Estate, hosted by me, Thomas F. Chappelle, Jr. See you in the two. Thanks.
The caring staff at Mac Flavor Ingredients reminds everyone to please take the opportunity to give blood. By doing so, you may save the life of a friend, child, elderly person, surgery patient, or an accident victim. So give blood. It's safe, simple, and saves lives. This important reminder is a courtesy of Mac Flavor Ingredients in Riverside, where they care about the safety and welfare of our community. Be a silent hero, and if you can, give the gift of life. Give blood.
If you're trying to quit drinking or doing too many drugs, listen to me. You don't know me and we'll never meet. I had a problem like you once. I drank and used to party a little too much till it got out of control and almost ruined my life. I realized I needed help to fix my problem before it totally destroyed me. If you've tried to fix your drinking and drug problem and you know you can't do it alone, you need to call the National Treatment Advisors. They'll immerse you into a 30-day program to replace your old habits with new habits and totally change your life. And if you have PPO private health insurance, the entire program may be covered. Fix your problem right now before it gets any worse. Get clean. Call now and learn more.
800-451-9716. 800-451-9716. 800-451-9716. That's 800-451-9716.
Well, welcome back to The Real Men of Real Estate, hosted by me, your host, Thomas F. Chappelle, Jr. We was entangled in a conversation with Bruce Blaylock, and we was talking about the credit side and how can it work for people. Now, when I got into investing, the two books that I was interested in, I mean, it was a bunch of them, but the two books I was interested in, which I was listening to audio because I can't stand reading. I love listening because I can take it with me everywhere I go, was the Rich Dad, Poor Dad, which everybody was interested in. And I got a different thing out of it than most people, you know, and I understand everybody talk about mindsets and things like that. But my outtake on it was that the highest plateau you can reach is, you know, go to school, get a PhD, and your ceiling is met. So that's where I look at the multiple income streams is when your ceiling is met. You know, you can't make no more money higher than what that degree will allow you to make. But the best book that I do love, and I tell everybody about it, is The Richest Man from Babylon. You know, because there is a biblical-based story out of it, but it also tells you and understand how to be able to build wealth. A lot of people understand or know, but then they cut corners when you got specific instructions on how to do it, but sometimes it takes longer than what people have, and that's called time. And a lot of people want things instantaneously instead of waiting that time because now you can appreciate better. So could you expound on that for me, please?
Sure. You know, it's interesting you mentioned Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I read that book also. And one of the strategies that we push and we teach is obtaining assets before you buy things like cars or even a home, is to create assets that generate income that can pay for these things so that you'll always be in a position of security. If you're buying lots of assets and they create debt for you, that, you know, that's definitely not a good thing, definitely according to Rich Dad, Poor Dad. And what I learned from him is the concept of before you buy these assets, these gifts to yourself, so to speak, is you want to create, you want to purchase or identify or obtain income-producing assets that creates, that services the debt or pays for those things. So that this way, you know, you, if you're worthy based on your ability to afford it comfortably. And the way that you're able to afford something comfortably is by having a, an asset in place that generates the income to service the debt on that particular asset. So, so yeah, his strategies, Robert Kiyosaki, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, are very sound, make a lot of sense, and I live by them myself.
Okay, now what about the book, The Richest Man in Babylon? What do you think about that?
Great concepts, really great concepts. The ideas and the methodologies and the techniques and systems that are portrayed in that is something that is just mind-blowing. And if you follow these strategies and these methodologies and these techniques and these systems, it can completely change your financial trajectory. A lot of people don't know, though, that the, one of the important things that they can do is to read and educate themselves. And books like, you know, that you've mentioned, as well as one of my favorites, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill.
Yes, sir.
Are books that, you know, are designed to change your you know, the way you process strategy, money, and finances, the way you work on building yourself and teaching yourself and educating yourself through visualization, through transmutation, through the desire of knowing exactly what it is that you want and putting in place the systems, the vehicles, and the methods to obtain that. You know, these are strategies that are as old as the mountains, but many people are unfamiliar with them. And just by reading, it's amazing what you can learn.
Now, here's the thing with you and me. I've told you this before, is that what you have taught me thus far, so forth, and it's always good to learn. You never can stop learning. Is that the things you're doing and helping people to grow businesses and things like that, is that you're like a Shaquille O'Neal or a Warren Buffett, where these people are teaching you how to go buy businesses, and then you don't have to worry about controlling. You just continue to reap the benefits from it, and that's what happened with Shaquille. Warren Buffett told him how to do that. Same thing that happened to Magic Johnson with Dr. Buss teaching him how to become an entrepreneur and stuff like that. People, you got to understand that there's a lot of people out there that can help you. Just the fact is, you got to learn how to trust people. Everybody's not out to get you. Trust is a big, major factor in everything that you do. You know what I'm saying? Because I tell people there's truth to lies and some lies to some truth. Because I am an educator, because I was educated, and I end up giving back what was given unto me. Now, before we go any further, here's the one thing I want to do ask that probably nobody ever asked before, is that if you had an opportunity to go back and talk to your younger self, what would you ask that person? What would you say to that person? Would you be doing what you're doing now, or would you be doing something totally different? Expound, please.
Wow, that's a great question. But I have a great answer for that. Two things I would do. The first thing is, because I would invest much more aggressively. One of the things that I've learned over the years is by just putting $250 to $500 in a mutual fund that usually gives a return of 8 to 12% as an average annually. If you were to put $250 to $500 in a mutual fund over the course of 20 years to 30 years, you would obtain $1 to $2 million in liquid capital. So I would aggressively invest. I would invest far more aggressively, trying to put at least $1,000 a month into an investment vehicle, so that at the age that I am right now, I'd be much more liquid with much more substantial capital. So that, and I recommend that for anyone. Coming out of college, if you could put your money in a Scudder fund, Vanguard fund, a very well-established mutual fund that tried and true gives a return of 8 to 12% statistically, I would do that as soon as possible as I got out of college and started working, making money. And I would stay the course, because you'll find that you'll be a millionaire within a fairly short period of time, and have the ability to do so many things, purchase your assets with cash. The other thing I would do is I would enter the entrepreneurial realm much earlier. When I graduated college, I did start a business with a business partner and some people I went to school with. It didn't, it wasn't very successful. It didn't last very long. It was exciting, but I didn't stay to it. I didn't get to be, I didn't turn to become an entrepreneur until I reached my my mid-30s. And had I gotten into the world of entrepreneurship much earlier and developed those entrepreneurial muscles, I'd be much further than I am right now. So developing your specialization as early as possible, exercising those entrepreneurial skills much earlier, and investing aggressively much earlier would be the things that I would say that I would have done differently, or that I would tell my younger self for sure. One of the things I also learned that I would have done earlier is when I first started my business in, as a management consultant firm, strategic advisory firm, I was raising capital for a lot of people. And over several years, I raised lots of funds for many entrepreneurs who were young and new, and sometimes $100,000 in cash and $100,000 in credit. And what I found is that many of them, although ambitious, weren't putting the money into the right places. They were putting it into their businesses, or they were blowing the cash and not putting it into their businesses at all because they weren't used to having money. Eventually, what that did is that led me to design a division of my business called Business Acquisition Services, which is the acquiring of income-producing businesses. I wish I had done that earlier, and I guess I needed to learn. And the reason why that I designed that business is because clients I was raising all this money for clients, and they weren't putting it into the right vehicles, or the vehicles they were putting into, which was often their own businesses, weren't cash flowing. So I had to design this business, this division of my business, that would enable me to help my clients create wealth and service debt and position themselves for generational wealth eventually. So I would have done that much earlier, and I would have had a greater legacy of success with clients in my earlier years rather than my later years.
Okay. So, Bruce, we get ready to take our last break here, and then we'll come back and wrap it up with you. And, man, I got to have you come back, man, because you got so many nuggets you've been dropping. I got to have you come back, man. I wish you could be in the studio, but we got to do this Zoom thing. So let's take our last commercial break, and we'll be back with our guest, Bruce Blaylock. This is the Real Men of Real Estate. Thank you.
What is your plan for your beneficiaries to manage your final expenses when you pass away? Life insurance, annuities, bank accounts, investment accounts, all require death certificate, which takes 10 days based on the national average, which means no money is immediately available, and this causes stress and arguments. Simple solution, the beneficiary liquidity plan. Use money you already have, no need to come up with additional funds. The funds grow tax deferred and pass tax free to your named beneficiaries. The death benefit is paid out in 24 to 48 hours without a death certificate. You heard me right. Without a death certificate. Call us at 1-800-306-5086.
FireUp Connect is the most innovative business networking group, supporting and collaborating with a dozen of small businesses that are interested in building and establishing strong business connections. Hosting educational live seminars while carrying out business and community-driven projects, as well as marketing programs as a part of its membership program. FireUp Connect also offers virtual assistance with a wide range of services, including inbound customer support, chat support, appointment setting and email management, graphic designing, video editing, web design and development, social media marketing, e-commerce solution, content writing and much more. For more information, head on over to www.fireupconnect.com. FireUp Connect. Helping success stories unfold every day.
Yeah. Well, welcome back to the Real Men of Real Estate, hosted by me, Thomas F. Chappelle Jr. Bruce, we're at that time that we have to let you go. So if you can be so kind to get out your information so if people want to contact you, they'll be able to do so.
Sure. My website is BCG, which is Blaylock Consulting Group, BCG-funding.com. Again, that's B as in boy, C as in cat, G as in girl, hyphen dash, funding, F-U-N-D-I-N-G.com. That's my website. On my website is my bio, my background, my consulting services, and a lot about my business and what I do. You can also reach me at 646-741-6521. Again, that number is 646-741-6521. One more time. Again, that number is 646-741-6521.
Hey, Bruce, I mean, it's been a pleasure. I would love to have you come back again. I'm sorry for the technical difficulties earlier. Like I said, I do wish you was in the studio, but we got to do this this new technology thing, and sometimes we got these bugs that we can't control. Ladies and gentlemen, it was a wonderful pleasure with Bruce Blaylock. Please give this gentleman a call because he is working things with me. I am one of his clients at the moment. Like I said, I am Thomas F. Chappelle Jr., your host with the Real Men of Real Estate. I also have a real estate investment club, which is every third Wednesday of the month, virtual, 6 p.m. for West Coast, 9 p.m. for East Coast. You can find me on Meetup. You can go to all my social media platform under Thomas, T-H-O-M-A-S, F like Frank, C like H, C like Charles, H like Harry, A like Apple, P like Paul, E like Edward, L like Larry, Jr. I love my name, so please check me out on all social media. My number here is area code 404-844-1828. Once again, that's area code 404-844-1828. Thank you very much, my guest, Bruce Blaylock. I don't know who I'm going to have as my next guest coming next month, but stay tuned. Have a wonderful day.